Let's do some very, very late night Fallout 3. And cough a whole bunch while we're at it. Where's my mouse? Where the hell is my mouse? There it is. I'm sure we'll find it eventually. Hi, Moth. Hi, Gamma. I'm sorry we're starting so late. I got called into work. Interesting. Hold on one sec. Alright, that's weird. My mouse... My escape key aren't working. What the hell? Okay, let's try this again. Let's exit the game. It's probably gonna crash. It's probably because I tabbed out to do other stuff. That was weird, though. Hey, Immortal Destroy 2. Are you back because you're a 2? No, kidding. That's weird, though, that it wasn't doing the thing. But hi! How is everyone? How are all three of you? And my kitten, who suddenly decided that she does not want to be in my lap. Okay, bye. Okay, bye! Alright, let's see if the mouse is going to show up today. Where the hell? What the fuck? It's not recognizing my mouse. Nor is it, it's not recognizing half the fucking controls. The fuck is going on? You are like tired? Then take a nap! Oh, yeah, the 360's fucking plugged in. Thank you, Moth. Alright, let's see if this works. Yay, I have a mouse again! Yay! Yes, Moth is helpful. He is just helpful. He is a moth. Which means that he is a hat. Alright, so. Out of my way, Clover. Let's see. Alright. Looks like... Okay, just look like... Hey, you could stay bored, bitch. Moths are hats, for those of you who don't know. So where do we want to go today? Rescue from Paradise. That's where we want to go. Let's do a quick save. Let's actually go to the world map like we're supposed to. I love how the dial turns. What we gonna do tonight, right? The same thing we do every night, Pinky. Try to and then I get copyright. We're gonna collapse like that. What we gonna do tonight, right? Same thing we do every night, Pinky. Get screwed over by copyright claims. Alright, kids.
Thanks for helping us, Mungo.
Stop calling me that. Stop calling me that. Home now.
You watch out, okay?
You ever make it to Little Lamplight? You come say hi. Okay, Mungo? You should come to Little Lamplight sometime, Mungo. You okay after all?
Oh, hold on. So where is little lamplight? Down there. So, guess where we're going today? Going to little lamplight. And then we might go drop off Dad, because he's getting annoying following me around all the time, like some sort of creepy stalker man. Liam Neeson or not. It's a bit weird. Mungo is just a pawn in the game of life. Mungo is just a pawn in the game of life. That's a reference to something, isn't it? Oh, I can just follow the kids. Oh shit, I missed.
Whoa. Are you like some kind of crazy person?
I'm trying to protect you, you freaks. I'm just aiming poorly. There we go. So, we'll make our way towards Little Lamplight, and we'll pick up anything. It's from Blazing Saddles. Gotcha. And, if we run across any interesting places, we'll jump into them. Like, we'll go explore them. I just saw Blazing Saddles yesterday. God, I wish SR-71 was still, like, a band that actually put out music. Hold on a sec. No, no! Let me up! Ah, you bastards. You bastards. Some sort of crazy person. Bitches, I'm the one protecting you.
Ooh, can I try?
Nice. Motherfucker never stood a chance. Excuse me. Oh, hell yeah. Fuck yeah. Leveled up, bitches. Alright, so let's see. Let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see. 21. Hmm. I guess we can finish off lock picking. And let's up our guns a whole bunch. No. I do want to finish off lock picking though, but let's do barter actually. Yeah, barter, definitely. Ooh, soft shell mired lurk meat. Nice. I'm on a boat, motherfucker. Oh, that's, I was like, what the fuck is that? But it's just the kids swimming. That was terrifying for a second there. Like, just for a second, that was terrifying. Alright, now let's see. There was a room I needed to go back to when I got my lock picking up to 100. There was a room and a place. What's with all these jaguar? I mean, aside from the fact that they're getting murdered. Hey, buddy. Notice me! Notice me, senpai! Damn, my aim is just terrible right now. Oh, for the love of shit. I like how when you look at that far, the texture just like, meh. And don't bother. Oh, there's another one. There we go. And thank you, Gamma. Huh. Looks like I'm not the first person to wander through here. Of course, I'm the one that survived it. We go towards a little lamplight. Oh. Hello. Come on. I got your attention. Do 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 do. What's that? Did I cripple your leg? Ah, cooked Deathclaw. Smells like victory. Hold on one sec, please. Smells like victory. Why are these guys all red? Why are you red?
Need some help with this one.
Oh.
Need some help with this one.
Hey, there's guys! Yo, whoa! That's what I was afraid of. Do anything to those guys.
Hey, where? Bring it.
You're clipping through the wall, buddy. Calm down. Oh, excuse me. Step back. Shale. Goddamn cat. Stupid ghouls just started shooting first and didn't even try to say hi, and we could have been friends. I love the creepy little, you know, the creaking of the corrugated steel. touches like that to make this game special. Abandoned shack, yeah. After killing all the locals. And then it's, and even then it's only mostly abandoned. Excuse me, Jesus. Whoa, oh, hey. Buddy. What the hell? We could have been friends if you hadn't started shooting me. Why'd you start shooting me? What did I do to you? Nothing. I just got here. Let's see. Is the shack actually abandoned? The shack is actually... Good lord. What the fuck happened here? Aside from a Skeleton breakdance! Jesus.
Please be careful.
Oh my god, don't scare me like that, James. Yes, the ambiance in this game is amazing. Like, that was one of the great things about it. It legitimately feels creepy all the time. Alright, how close to the little lamplight am I? I still got a ways to go. But, we can check out what's up here first. That's not a door? That's a shame. That is a shame. Okay. Had to do a sweep over my HUD. Let's not go into that. Uh-oh, I hear a music change. But I see no enemies. Freaking me out, game. Faking me out. Okay, so I want to know what this little marker is. No, don't make there be an invisible wall. Come on. There you go. There you go. Let me up. Come on. Nice. Love me some wall jumping. Love it. Gilbert Brothers, a waste of spook. Hold on a moment. I'm fairly certain. Hold on. Let me pause it so that the music isn't doing that stupid thing. I'm fairly certain one of the bobbleheads is down here. I'm sorry about the repeating music. Let's see. Uh, Oh no, it's the greener pastures disposal site. Never mind. Okay, never mind. Fuck me! It's times like this where I wish I had the camera on, because you would have just seen me flinch. Oh my god. Not gonna look at it, not gonna look at it, not gonna look at it. Not looking at it. Because those things freak me the fuck out. I don't know why, they just do. Oh, there's a shack over here. I see you. I thought I got it. Okay, that's legitimately kind of hilarious. But oh my god, terrifying. Why are you so fast? No, no. Nah, I hate looking at it. I'm not looking at it. Okay. Ooh, the moon. Wow, the moon is actually moving. That's pretty cool. God, I hate being congested. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm not even gonna loot the damn thing. I don't even care. Fuck it. I'm out. I'm out. That's how much I hate those things. Yeah, whatever you're doing, you should probably knock it off. I wish I could just get rid of sick. So much. Oops. Whoops. I know you're still down here. Can I just hit you in the head, please? Fine, fine, fine! Joik. So anyway, where are we? losing progress by jumping down a mountain. Like idiots. Sounds like this is the game. I wish the game was more like WoW, where I can just jump up walls. That is super ineffective. Super ineffective. Yeah. No, God, no. Oh my God, I hate these things. No, please don't. Okay. Super mutants I can deal with. Even the masters. Mutant massacre perk. Nice. What's that perk do? It's probably just an extra like 5% to killing super mutants. Alright, yep, bonus to killing him. Wait, I am Lord Death. Getting damage bonus to everything! Because I like killing everything. Nice. Cool. Why are they killing those innocent brahmin? Those poor Brahmin. All right, let me switch back to my railway rifle. Bye. I can blind fire like a pro. Sorry, Brahmin. Let's kill or be killed. Yeah, the textures just said, fuck it, we're done. Oh, there they go. Where is this other Brahmin? Eh, whatever. They're there. At least they died together. Yeah, the momentum sent it over me, which is pretty hilarious. The game's just like, you forgot Dad. You forgot him. He's back. Yeah, whatever. We give up. So this is little lamplight. These kids are pretty ineffective if they're not taking the stuff that's right here in the front. We did never think to check that house. Okay. Gifts, crafts, fun. Mungoland with an arrow pointing down. I guess they mean out. It says stop. Visit Lamplight Caverns. No Mungos.
Hold it right there, lady.
Here you are, MacReady.
Don't take another step or we'll blow your fucking head off.
Hold on there. I'm a friend.
You're big. And I don't have any big friends. You better just go out the way you came in.
What is this place?
This is Little Lamplight. We live here, and we don't need no mungos messing it up. So just take a hike.
Tell me more about Little Lamplight, kid.
Why would I tell you anything? God, you're dumb.
So who are you?
I'm MacReady. I run Little Lamplight, because they made me the mayor. I don't like strangers or mungos.
Can I come in?
Hell no! No mungos allowed!
You know what? Your face looks like my butt! Why is that so funny? Oh, you know what? Your face looks like my butt!
Oh yeah? You must like having such a good looking butt.
Oh, that was the best comeback for it too! Yeah, well, at least it doesn't smell as bad as you do.
You're pretty funny for a mungo. Why don't you come on in?
Happy birthday, Sticky. Sorry I missed your party.
Yeah, me too. Sorry.
There's nothing happy about it. This is the worst day of my life.
It's time to go.
You know the rules.
The rules are stupid.
You're a mungo now. You gotta leave.
Maybe I can stay just a little longer?
Hey.
Bye, Sticky.
Yeah. Bye, Sticky.
Don't just stand there. Get out of here.
What's
already.
Up?
Fun times and laughs is all.
Wow. What luck. I'm Sticky. Forget these little kids. I'll take you to Big Town where the mungos, I mean where the grown-ups live. I'm headed there now.
Where the grown-ups live?
Big Town. You've never heard of it? It's where all the grown-ups go. Well, at least when they grow up and out of Little Lamplight.
Perk well spent.
There's no reason to waste your time with a bunch of snot-nosed kids. Let's go now.
Fine, I'll take you to Big Town, but first I need to visit Little Lamplight.
I'm not allowed in Little Lamplight anymore. Only people under 18 get to live in Little Lamplight. So when you're done with those little kids, we can go to Big Town together. I'll wait outside for you.
Okay, bye.
All right. Hey, new kids. I don't know if anyone told you yet, but let me set the record straight.
I'm a total bitch.
When you're around me, I'm in charge. You shut up and do what I say, because I'm boss around here. That clear? Now, who are you?
Whatever you say.
Good. Glad we got that settled. Stay out of my way and there won't be any problems.
How did someone like you get a nickname like Princess?
I don't need to explain myself to you, Mungo. Shut up and get lost.
Wow, you're kind of a bitch.
Don't you ever bother me about something as stupid as nicknames again.
Wow. How do I know this? What's that, guarding the back gate?
It's so dull. Practically nothing ever tries to come through the back gate anymore, so I never get to shoot anyone. I wish I was at the front gate. but RJ specifically put me back here. Up front, at least there's a chance I can shoot some unwanted visitors. Which could have included you, Mungo.
Why would you have shot me?
Could have been a lot of reasons. Maybe you sounded like a monster in all that darkness. Maybe you had a weapon drawn and looked like a raider. Maybe I just decided I didn't like your stupid Mungo face.
Right. So can you give me directions?
No, scram.
God. This is why I hate kids. Sarah was eating during that little exchange. Okay, goodbye.
Bye. Hey, duck.
Wow, you're big. I mean, bigger than most people down here. Bigger than most people down here that we don't shoot for being down here. So how'd you get down here without getting shot? Am I supposed to shoot you? Because you know, I'd rather not. But if I'm supposed to, then okay.
No, you don't mean to shoot me. Just think of me as a big kid.
That's good. They don't like me having my gun in town, so I gotta turn it in first. So if I had to shoot you, you'd have to wait a bit. My name's Zip. I don't think that's short for anything. Because I don't know what it'd be short for. Zippy, Zipperick, Zipthalamu. So yeah, it's good to meet you, big kid. Maybe you've got big stuff on top of you. Do you have any Nuka-Cola, maybe? Yes? Please?
Why are you called Zip?
Why Zip? Or why do I have a nickname at all? Why don't people just call me Ricky, or Yancey, or Eustace P. Vanderbagger III? They say it's because I'm so fast. But that doesn't make sense because I don't think I'm all that fast. It's just that they're all slow. I guess it's just one of those mysteries that'll never really get answered. Sort of like how people made bubbles in Nuka-Cola. Say, got any cola?
You said you were looking for Nuka-Cola?
Yeah, more Nuka's always good. It's definitely always gooder than less. Because no Nuka's no good at all. Got any Nuka for me? I'll trade you whatever I got for more Nuka-Cola. Anytime. Nuka for Zip. Nuka for Zip.
What have you got to trade for an ice-cold bottle of Nuka-Cola?
Well, I found a lucky bullet this morning. It's just a measly old 10 mil. But I know for sure it's lucky because it was sitting there all alone out of its clip and not fired off. Want it?
Sounds like a good deal. Good trade to me. Here.
Yay! Nuka-Cola, Nuka-Cola makes the stomach bubbly and the world so jumbly. Yay!
I got a 10mm round. Huh. Got anything else for a Nuka?
That's all I got right now. Come back tomorrow, maybe we'll have more. And you can have more Nuka. For me to have more Nuka. Yeah?
I'm going away. You stay here. Away from me.
Okay. See you next time, miss.
What are you... New in town, huh? Well, if MacReady let you in, that's a good sign. I'm Knock-Knock, and I take care of keeping the peace down here. Or at least the morale. So who are you? You going to cause any trouble?
I'm from Vault 101. I rescued some of your friend from slavers.
Oh, that was you? Nice work. I
hope yes, she is.
Laughs out of it before you left. Gotta make sure they know not to try that again. Speaking of which... I'm Knock-Knock, and I take care of the general morale around here. Which
you mentioned.
Say, I collect a lot of stories, and sometimes trade them to keep the others amused. Morale's better than less al, see?
Why are you called Knock-Knock?
Well, when people started calling Nikki by his new name, I needed one too, see? If you're twins, it just doesn't cut it to be called Knick-Knack and Sue.
Right. You said you're in charge of morale? What does that mean?
Well, technically, I'm patrolling and keeping the peace.
Shoot,
mostly,
kitten.
That involves making sure people are happy and not getting into trouble. You can't very well keep the peace if you've already lost it, see? So, bam! Jokes. Wanna hear one?
I'm gonna regret this. Sure, let's hear one.
Prepare to be amused. Knock-Knock.
Who's there?
Noah.
Noah who?
Know a place where I can get some food?
Well, you've got better material than some comics I've seen.
Gee, thanks. I have to admit most of them aren't really funny. At least not ha-ha funny. They're more like a tradition. Most of them were passed down from this book we found down back, called Vault Boy's Big Book of Laughs for Kids. They're not really funny, but something about hearing them is a little comforting, you know?
Why don't you come with new jokes or stories to tell?
Oh, we've got lots of funny incidents. Like when Sammy shot the raider who thought he was a girl. That sort of stuff. But we don't really get a lot of new stories from outside. The scav teams spend all their time hidden, so they don't get much news, see? I'd sure like to hear more tales from the great big outdoors myself. Actually, if you hear any, feel free to tell me.
I'm Knock Knock. I have a circular dialogue tree, and my name is Knock Knock. I got a tale that I could tell you.
Oh, really? Tell me about it.
Let's see. Long ago, my people were buried away. Now I've arisen to terrorize the wastelands. Nah, not long ago my father left me, so I went searching for him.
So you're like a three-legged dog then? Looking for your lost paw? Anyway.
Moth, I hate you for this. I'll tell you more, but I'm still working on how it ends.
That makes sense, I suppose. A good story can take a while to put together, you know.
Alright, goodbye.
Later. You're so happy.
Hey there. You have any new...
Nope. Nope.
About. Bye. New in town, huh? Pretty let you in. That's good enough for me. Well, enough with formalities. Who are you? And how'd you get MacCready to let you in here?
From Vault 101, and I rescued some of your friends from the slavers.
Well, that was you? Nice work. I hope one of you grabbed some of their gear before you left. Gotta make them pay for something like that. Speaking of which, I'm Knick Knack, and I take care of the general store around here. Which is to say, I collect a lot of stuff, and sometimes trade it for other stuff. That's pretty much the story, see?
How is it your fault that the game has bad puns? Because you make bad puns, too. Alright, let's see. Why are you called Knick Knack?
Well, my name was Nick, and I collect knickknacks. Not everything has to be real complex, see?
You can't see it when I'm squinting at the game. Alright, can you repair
sure,
something?
Let me see.
I actually don't need any of this stuff repaired. Shale, come on. My cat's a fucking weirdo. She jumps up in front of the mirror that's on the other side of the room, and she just stares at it and mews. Like, not even a meow, like a straight-up kitten little meow. Like a little mule with an M. Or with an L on the end. Cat! That is not what I was trying to say how cute you were. Knock it off. Bitch.
Watch it. Hello. How are you doing? Okay. Bye.
Wow. Am I glad to be back. If it weren't for you, I think we'd have died back there. So, thanks for the help. If anyone asks me, you're an official kid.
Why are you called Squirrel?
I like to think it's because of my inquisitive and charming nature, as well as my natural climbing ability. But Knock Knock says it's because I'm totally nuts. Guess which one's probably right.
Take care, Squirrel.
I'll try.
Thanks again for saving me. You're the best.
You still got that collar on.
Me and my brother are tired for the best, at least. But that's still really good.
Why do you have the nickname Penny?
It's not a nickname. My name's Penelope. They're just lazy and don't like saying the whole thing is all.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks for getting us back here. We would have got out before long, but you did really help. So, thanks.
What is Princess Hater nickname?
So, a long time ago, Princess convinced everyone that she should be mayor. The first thing she did as mayor was try to insist the title be changed to Princess. It was 5 minutes before MacCready punched her in the nose and got picked as the new mayor. It was awesome!
She was only mayor for 5 minutes?
Yeah, MacCready said we needed someone to watch out for us, not to lord over us. Then he popped her one. She hasn't even tried since then. That's why he stays mayor, too. I hope it can be that
Shale.
Someday.
Does she still hold a grudge against him?
No way. I think she's got a crush on him. She's all weird for him.
Thanks, Sammy. That's useful information.
Thanks. Maybe you can take her down a peg, huh?
Oh, yeah. Do you enjoy guarding the back gate?
No, because Princess always bosses me around, and there's never nothing to gun. She's always making fun of me just because she's angry all the time about her nickname and not being in charge and stuff.
Alright. Thanks, buddy. Alright, let's see. Hey, Rex.
You're new, and you're too big to be a resident.
So much talking. I rescued those captured kids. I'm a big hero.
You brought back Penny and Sammy and Squirrel? Well, I guess that does make you a pretty big hero. Thanks. I'm Lucy, and I'm pretty much the mom around here. And that means I spend a lot of time kissing boo-boos and making things all better. So if you ever get any scrapes or bruises, or if you get shot, stabbed, or radiated, stop by, and I'll do what I can, big hero.
Cool. How do you keep healthy here?
There's always one big sister or another who knows her way around a compress and a sewing needle. So we take care of most of the little scrapes. And way back when, someone figured out that some of the plants and fungus around here absorb radiation. The little ones don't like to eat their veggies, but they don't like to be sick either. So we get by.
So you're the only doctor in this whole place?
Well, we all know the basics. Combat first aid, you know? But I've got the most experience at the tough stuff. Bumble's been learning the most about the more complex parts of cutting and sewing. People tease her, but she's got a steady hand. Of course, now she just needs to learn what you do and don't cut.
Huh. So anyway, that fungus sounds like it's pretty useful.
It is, especially for dealing with the low-level radiation we all get from the water. The fungus just soaks it right up. But it doesn't help the rickets that keep hitting the younger lamplighters. Believe it or not, I can make a treatment for that from extract of buff out. Actually, if you can talk MacReady into it, I'd be glad to trade some fungus for buff out, but he'd have to say it was okay.
Huh. Interesting.
Well, until you come asking for a bandage at least.
Cool. Thank you. I'll let you get back to work.
Well, here's something I don't see every day. A new face and little lamplight. A bit big for one of our kids. But you seem all right. What's your story down here?
All right. Mayor MacReady let me in for rescuing those kids.
That was you? Well, my most sincere thanks, then. You brought my sister Penny back to me, and I couldn't ask more than that. I'm Joseph, and if there's ever anything I can do for you, just name it. As the oldest kid in town, I spent most of my time teaching, but I do what I can to keep the kids clean and fresh-faced. Say, if you're ever looking for a haircut, I'd be glad to offer my services. You only have to ask.
What sort of education do kids get here?
Well, back at the start, all the children had were the notes from the grown-ups that hadn't left yet, and a few books on caves from the store. But after finding the vault, a few scavengers brought back holotapes for basic schooling, reading, basic math, encyclopedias, that sort of thing. We don't get many books anymore from the scav team, but I make sure to keep my own notes on the computer for whoever takes over after I leave.
What do you teach the kids?
Mostly whatever they want to learn. We don't have strict classes or anything down here, but it does mean they're interested in what I'm teaching. But everyone learns the basics of fighting and shooting and survival. We've all got obvious reasons to be interested in that.
How thorough are your teaching materials?
We entered all of the books and holotapes into the computer, but frankly, there are a lot of important subjects the Vault's material didn't cover. I could wish for more, but we're probably still the best school in the Wasteland. Maybe the only school in the Wasteland, really.
Hmm.
Glad I can...
Cool.
Whoa! You're big! You must be the biggest kid here! I'm the littlest kid. My real name's Betty, but mostly I get called Bumble. What are you called, big kid?
Sometimes people call me the Vault Dweller. It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too.
Did you? I am in Little Lamplight, yes.
I heard there's monsters down there. Eclair told me once, one of them, they got him and bit him right in the face, and that's why he's only got one eye. But you don't look like a monster, and I don't think you'd bite anyone in the face.
I mean...
You look like a nice Vault Dweller.
Why do they call you Bumble?
It's just a name, okay? Not my fault I knocked stuff over. Lucy says, I still got a lot of growing to do.
Okay. Bye-bye, Bumble.
Bye.
Alright, time to steal from children. Yes, I'm going to. No, I don't care. Kids deserve it, they're assholes. Most people in the wasteland are, though. Most people in the wasteland are. Essentials. Alright, where's MacCready so I can talk to him again? Crate chamber and spelunkers. And then suddenly the game is just spelunky. Let's see, we'll go to the souvenir shop first. This place is a lot bigger than I remember. There's MacCready.
Look, I don't just let any bitch into my town, and I'm taking a risk making an exception for you. So, you're welcome in my town. At least until you start screwing up. Once that bullshit starts, you're out on your own again.
I'm planning on starting any trouble.
Good. Better stay that way, Mungo.
So, I heard a lot about a fungus in your cavern, and I'd like to make a deal.
Yeah, I'll bet you've heard all about the fungus in my cavern. Yeah, the cave's fungus, sure. It's good for food and medicine. And it's the main fucking reason we've stayed alive down here. So, you want a slice of that gray-green gold, huh? I think maybe we could come to an arrangement. What are you offering?
I bring in needed supplies and I get some fungus in return.
Well, it'd lighten the load for our scav team a lot. Since you're pretty much one of us, here's the deal.
Alright.
Every piece of fungus.
Yeah, I had the child at heart one.
Be repaid with one cube of fungus. You couldn't ask for a better deal. Talk with
all the kids are sent out when they grow would be infinitely better than a little lamplight. Yeah.
They've got uses for them.
And yes, MacCready is definitely the most foul-mouthed cretin in the game. Alright. See you around, MacCready.
Yeah, that's nice. Scram.
You little shit. I like MacCready. You little shit. He's the kind of kid you want to punch in the face and then ruffle his hair and say he's doing a good job. Because most likely he's doing a good job. The little shit. Yes, I'm making sure I'm still hidden before I steal anything.
Hey.
All Are we gonna really do this? Thank you. Okay. So let's see. Ooh, boxing tape, nice. So, let's see. Just try to consolidate as much stuff as we can. Keep that because their charger rifle is really cool. And I'll use the keep the plasma pistol because we've got plenty of laser pistols back at the thing. Boxing tape though. Good shit there. Okay, enough of that. At least I got a has he got it in his hand in game? Seems that way. Alright, let's go to the Great Cavern then. Wait, no. Let's go back here first. Let's see what he was looking at back here. Back here. It's just Rex. I just want to see the back gate.
What's up, Mungo?
I know why you're really called Princess. Princess.
Why? Because I'm Princess a Little Lamplight?
You don't have to be embarrassed by it. Not everyone can be a good mirror. Or a good mayor. Nah, well, I hear Makuti really robbed you when you tried to play Princess.
Oh, yeah? Well, that was a long time ago. Now RJ's my best friend. Someday, we're gonna be boyfriend and girlfriend, and then he'll kick you out.
Really? Funny how I spend most of his time with Lucy, then.
That's not true! You're a liar! Shut your stupid face, liar! I know RJ likes me. He really does. Really! Just leave me alone.
The recharge rifle comes in handy if I need a cyber lib. Yep. Bitch.
Watch it.
Alright, so.
Hey, hi.
Okay, no. Stay away from me. Out of my face, MacCready. Fuck PN convergence. What? Oh, because of mod. Okay. Alright, so let's go down this way. Food. Hello, Eclair.
RJ let in another pair of choppers to eat up all our food.
I thought you only had one eye.
As long as you don't give me any crap about how I prepare your grub, I guess you'll be okay. So tell me, what do you think of cave fungus and watery mushroom sauce?
I'd rather eat a ramen turd sandwich with no bread.
You got that right. After our regular meals, I bet some of us would give that a shot. If we had a ramen down here, that is. Listen, my name's Eclair. Don't laugh. and I'm in charge of the food down here.
Yes, that is a badass hat.
I do what I can to spice it up. If you need a meal down here, just talk with me. You'll hardly even know you're eating cave mold.
I'd like some food.
Bon appetit.
Why are you called Claire?
Well, I didn't get the meat fat and full of cream. That's what you're asking. Back when I was on the scav team, I found some pages from an old cookbook. Sometimes I'll try them out. Just for the record, don't try making an eclair out of cave fungus. The taste sticks with you, and not in a good way.
Where do you get food from this place?
Honestly, when we can't scavenge some from outside, we mostly scrape it off the walls and skim it off the water. No, really. Most of our food comes from fungus that grows in these caves. It's not so bad when you get used to it. And we don't have much choice. At least it's filling. So we don't have to eat much of it. But man, oh man, it tastes terrible.
Where does the fungus come from?
It's pretty hard to find. And I hear it doesn't grow in other caves. I don't know why it's here, but without it, we'd be goners. You think fungus just grows on trees? No, it grows in caves. Ugh. Knock Knock came up with that one once, and now it's stuck in my head forever. Doesn't take any work to get it to grow down here. All I have to do is collect and prepare it. Mostly, I try to get the stink off it.
How does the fungus grow?
They say the fungus grows in the pools where the first lamplighters sent the Mungos. That's about the most they ever helped us. I don't know how true that is, but I know sometimes the scav team comes back with a strange meat. It's terrible, but the fungus loves it. I don't know where they find that meat, but if you could bring some back, I'd be glad to trade fungus for it. Of course, McCready'd have to okay it.
Oh my god. Cannibal motherfuckers. Alright, that's all you need to know for now.
Sure.
Why don't you get back to the food. Alright, Eclair. Wow, that was easy. Mine! Mine. Bitch ass kids.
Watch it.
What did I do? Alright, into the great chamber we go. Get out of my way, kids. Let's see what this great chamber is all about. Okay, that's pretty great. I feel like there's like 12 different Rexes in here. Oh, because that's Pete. Well. Chocolate cereal and vanilla almond milk? Pfft, just drink cow mucus. Oh my god, my throat closed up on that. I'm sorry. Hey, McCready.
Okay, so you get in, but I got my eye on you. You don't make any trouble in here, got it? I ain't having no shit butts making trouble. Good.
Let's see, make a deal. Okay.
Well, but yeah, okay, so.
Okay, already did that. Okay, so. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. Hey, Ginger. God, there are a lot of dogs here. A lot of dogs. Man, this place is gonna go to hell whenever I start fighting. I remember having to have a big fight up here before. a good thing I can loot it all now.
Hey.
Where to? Maybe this one? Or is this where I came in? I'm lost. What's over here? A dead fucking end. Alright, so those are the ways out. Means that I haven't been this way yet. Nothing. Keep out, not part of tour. Which dog is this? This is a hooligan. Nice. That said, almond milk tastes better anyway. The terminal is not powered. Shit. Alright, whose ass do I have to pickpocket for this? Preferably not their actual ass. Alright, let's see. So I just need to find out where that one goes. Excuse me. Sorry, guys. These hiccups are killing me. One of the little brats has the ability to repower it. Yeah, I figured as much. Any idea who? It's broke and that someone forgot the password, so they shut it off. Oh, Lord. Do you happen to remember who? Okay. Maybe Jacob? I haven't met a Jacob yet. Let's find out. Sorry about the clicky noisy thingy, but... Oh, it's Joseph who does? Okay. I know where he is, at least. Alright, let's, So easy to get lost here. Oh, God.
No way to Lamp Light. Hey, you look like you're handy with the weapon. I got kicked off the scab team, so I guess I don't need mine anymore. Wanna buy my Wazer rifle? 500 caps, and it's all yours.
How about giving it to a fellow kid like me?
That's a great idea. You take it and good luck out there.
Dumbass. I got a Wazer rifle. Ways a wifel is a good wifel. Seems that way. Alright, let's see. So now I just gotta find Joseph. Joseph. Jose Piff. Now we'll have. Now you hunt wabbits.
Oh, hey, excuse me, hey.
Oh, hello, Lucy.
Yes.
Oh, right. Got buff out for fungus.
Excellent. I should be able to synthesize the proteins from this into something that'll fight rickets. Here's your fungus. Well?
Okay, bye. I just gotta find Joseph. Yeah. I just gotta find him. I think. It's Penny. Joseph.
What's happening?
Alright, let's see. Directions. Nah, nah, nah. Alright, hold on. Let's... Oh man, the slave call instructions. Don't tinker with the collar, you'll probably blow yourself up, which would serve you right. The Meser Array triggers the collar's self-destruct mechanism, so once the collar's on, don't shoot the slave with the Mesmatron, unless you want to pay me for a new collar. If you lose the collar, or get it stolen for you, you'll end up wearing one. We don't tolerate any threat to our business. If you have any questions, piss off! I don't have time for retards. List of recruits, schematic for the nuka grenade, nice. Medic power armor manual. Alright, let's see. Journal of Carrie Delaney.
My name is Carrie Delaney. I teach fourth grade at the Early Dawn Elementary School in Washington, D.C. Yesterday, October 23rd, 2077, half the school went on a field trip to Lamplight Caverns. We were packing up to leave when... Everything went crazy. The cave started shaking, the lights went out, the kids started screaming. My God!
Mr. Moira's voice.
Went outside to see what was going on. When he came back in, he told us what he saw. Clouds. Mushroom clouds. It's finally happened. The end of the world.
Alright, so that's one.
We're all okay, if you can call being stuck in a cave with 82 terrified kids okay. Alive, anyway. I don't know what the hell we're going to do. It's been 4 days. Claudia went out this morning to look around and never came back. Then Mr. Cobb went out to look for her, and he never came back. So now there's only me, two other teachers, two of the parents who were chaperoning, and a few of the cavern staff. And all these poor kids. We've got enough food and water to last for a while, I guess. But after that, I just don't know. We can't stay in here forever.
Hey,
can we?
All right then. See ya.
Alright, fungus trade. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Let's see. Lucy Eclair. Lucy trade fungus for buff out doses. Keep those rickets treatment Cummings. Claire trade fungus for strange meat. That should keep the fungus in the pools fertilized. Anybody's got a fucking problem with this set of answers to me. God, MacReady's awesome. Little Lamplight.
We've been in here for 3 months now, and it's way better than it used to be. Who says kids can't take care of themselves? Jason has done a really good job keeping everyone busy. He says if we want to survive, we need to work together and work hard. A few of the kids have started saying, we're like a whole new city. A city of kids. They call it Little Lamplight. It's so cool. All of us voted, in secret. And tomorrow, we're going to tell Jason that he's the city's first mayor. He's going to be so happy with us.
I guess this thing is working. I'm Jason Grant. I'm 10 years old. I'm in Miss Delaney's class at Early Dawn Elementary. A month ago, a big war came and everything was destroyed. Except us. We're still okay in these caves. Kind of. Mrs. Delaney went out this morning to get help. And she never came back. The other adults never came back either. So now it's just us kids. A lot of the others still cry every day. They're really scared. I'm not. There's nothing to be scared of, as long as we don't go outside. Nobody else wants to be in charge, so I'm gonna try. Most of the kids listen to me already, so it should be easy.
Alright, one sec. I'm looking up how to get into this stupid thing. Okay, so I can't do it yet. Okay, so I can't do it yet because it's I'm here too early.
It's
you have
been
a kitten.
Almost 2 months, and we're all doing pretty good, even if we are all alone. There's a door that leads to a vault right here in the caverns. Every day we bang and bang, but they won't let us in. We can hear them in there. One time, a guy on the other side told us we were dead already. Fuck those grown-ups. Fuck them all. We don't need them ever again.
Okay, so yeah, we're here a little bit early. We're not supposed to be here yet, so that might be why we're not getting in. So, we'll come back. Apparently we have to finish the Waters of Life first. Which is, like, why we're not finding the thing. So let's go do some of the main quest for a little bit, since tonight's going to end up being a short stream thanks to the fact that I got called into work. So we'll do that. Shut up. You're going to Mongo
Land. Big town? Of course you do.
What's with the party hat?
Oh, I forgot I had that on. It was for my birthday. Here, you take it. I don't want it anymore.
Where's Big Town located?
It's east of Little Lamplight. Come on, let's go there. It's not that far away. We'll be there in no time.
All right, let's go to Big Town.
All right, yeah! Big Town, here we come.
Big Town. I'm gonna fuck this kid up. Apparently you can shoot him.
Are you lost?
And nobody gives a shit. Apparently. Dad has to be dead. My dad is dead! Dead.
Are you sure you know where you're going? I mean...
For the love of God, shut the hell up! Just quit talking. You stop
talking!
Zip it!
You zip it first!
Not playing this game.
Whatever.
You're gonna need a weapon.
Oh, wow! Cool! What have you got for me? Minigun? Flamer? Maybe a missile launcher?
I'm gonna give him... I could give him the Wazer rifle. Nah, let's just give him an SR carbine, because we don't need any more of them. Alright, enough chit chat. Alright, where the hell are we going? There's no such thing as Big Town, is there? Oh no, it's right there. Good boxing tape. I'm gonna take on that Deathclaw. Oh no, tape. Yeah. No, I don't want to give him the boxing tape because I want to keep that.
Why is this taking so long?
Oh, dude. No, no, don't make me fight this stupid thing. No, 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 no. Okay, that was kind of silly. That was legitimately kind of silly. Ow. That's why it's doing it. Okay. Oh, I missed his head. Oh, nice. Alright, so anyway, stupidity aside,
I know.
Should give that kid a rocket launcher.
Once upon a time, there was this dog. His name was Joking Joe, and he went all around making everyone laugh really hard at all his funny jokes.
He's a dog, he can't talk, you stupid shit.
And one day, a giant ant came up to him and started talking like he wasn't some dumb ant. Are we there yet?
Shut the hell up.
What?
You're annoying. You'd better make this worth my time.
Yeah. I got tons of caps at Big Town. Well, they're not mine, really.
Hi, Royal Blue.
My girlfriend's got them. Her name's Red. She's a doctor, so she's sure to have lots of money. She'll give them to you for making sure I get there safely.
Hey, who are you?
I'm Queen of the Wasteland. What does it matter? Let me in or not? No, I mean you no harm. I'm in some trouble.
Right. What do you want?
Do you harass all your visitors like this?
Well, you can never be too careful. Be warned, it's not safe here. Super mutants attacked recently and carried off some of our friends. Come in. Just don't cause any trouble, okay?
I know, right? It's always the same voices. Big trouble in Big Town. This doesn't look like Little China. Wait. I did indeed discover Big Town.
Hey, look at me. I'm in Big Town.
Shut up. Yeah. Strangling would be a good idea.
A visitor? Who'd want to visit this hellhole? I'll bet you're here to rape and pillage us, aren't you? Aren't you?
Not that it only matters. You.
Super mutant snacks, anyway.
Looking for a woman named Red. Sticky promised me some caps.
Red was the only decent person in this hellhole, and the mutants took her in the raid. Sticky is a doofus, but I bet Red will cover his debts. But you probably shouldn't tell Sticky Red's gone. I don't want one more crybaby wandering around here causing a ruckus. It's bad enough already.
Hmm. What do you know about the super mutants?
The only thing you need to know is that we're all doomed. Sooner or later, they'll get every last one of us. What are you supposed to be anyway? Some kind of hero here to rescue our friends from the muties? Bah! You're just here to cause trouble.
Don't lose hope. Do you know where the super mutants are located?
They took them north to that old police station in Germantown. No use in going up there, though. They've already been eaten, or worse, by now. Why? You thinking about performing a miracle and rescuing their sorry butts?
I got what it takes to rescue friends, but it's gonna cost you.
Just what I thought. You're a mercenary. We don't need you. Go on up there to die if you like, but don't say you're doing it for us.
All right, well, do you know where they took your friends?
Well, if you feel like dying, go right on ahead. They're up there at some police station near Germantown. Good luck. You're gonna need it.
Jeez. Jerk.
Hey,
Flash.
Don't get any bright ideas about trying anything. We may not look it, but every one of us is a trained killer. Oh, who am I kidding? Look, we're in trouble here. If you want to help, great. If not, just please don't kill anyone while you're here.
Trouble? What kind of trouble?
Well, we've got super mutants out that way and slavers up that way. Take your pick. They both come in here, drag off as many as they can carry, and shoot whoever puts up a fight. The best we can ever hope for is that they get here at the same time and fight over who gets to kill us.
Why don't you leave?
And where are we going to go? Megaton won't have us, Lamplight won't take us back, and Rivet City is too far. Besides, the bunch of us can't even hold this town. Can you imagine us schlepping across the wasteland?
Schlep? Who lives here?
There aren't many of us left. There's me and Pappy. Red runs the clinic, but she's been taken by the mutant. Kimba does what she can. And there's Bittercup. She's just about as useless as a human being can be. Time Bomb was hurt in the last raid, so he's out. That's about it. The mutants and slavers have taken everyone else. Just us and a couple of guns are all that's left.
Okay. So it's pretty much free-for-all here. Where do you keep your good stuff?
Yeah, yeah. You're a scary wastelander. Look, you'll either kill us or you won't. Most of us have already accepted death, so you won't get much of a reaction with your threats.
But you look different from the vault.
If you shoot us all.
Not bad, kid. I'll let you live. For now.
Aren't you swell? Did you need something else, or can I go back to my patrol?
Alright, I'll let you leave.
Keep an eye out for muties.
So I'm eating during the dialogue-y parts. Hold on. Kitten? Aww. That's an adorable cat. Mine's going after my pizza. She ain't gonna get it. Hey, Kimba.
Welcome to Big Town. Not that there's much of a town left. Those super mutants keep kidnapping people.
Huh. You know where they took your friends?
Oh, they're somewhere to the northeast. In a police station or something. Thanks for rescuing our friends.
Where'd you people come from? God damn it, cat!
The Lamplight is where most of us came from. Red and Pappy and Flash and Bittercup. We used to play together when we were kids. Then we got old and we had to leave. Those were the rules. So we packed up and headed here, like we were supposed to.
Fucking cat.
No one told us it would be like this. We never have fun anymore. And most of us are dead.
Whew. Alright, well,
so
goodbye.
Tired of being frightened all the time.
Like, that's a somber thing to say. All right, bye. You love Calico so much, not your cat. Oh. Hey, it's an ophthalmoscope. Oh, I'm over encumbered. Let's get rid of the missile launcher. I don't think we need that. Alright, you know what? I hate to do this, guys, but I need to cut the stream short. I was gonna at least go until midnight, and I was thinking about going for even longer, but I gotta stop. So here's what we'll do. We're just gonna straight up stop, like, right here. And, learn that first. We're gonna quick save, and I'll be back tomorrow in the morning. I do apologize, but, yeah. My stomach just suddenly said, no, I don't agree with anything you're doing. And, yeah. So, let me make sure we do an actual save, just in case. And I'm really sorry, guys. We'll pick this up tomorrow, and since I don't have work, we'll make sure to do a full 4 hours, okay? So, thanks for being here, and I do apologize for knocking out real quick and kind of suddenly. But we'll pick it up tomorrow, and we'll make sure we do the full 4 hours. So, have a good night, everyone.